bring us the king. Bring us the rope. Bind his hands, bind his feet. Throw his body into the sea, and our people shall be free. Basenji, Basenji, greatest of countries, your only love, and we pledge our lives to thee. Basenji, Basenji, greatest of countries, victory for us, death to our enemies.
Hello everybody, it's the Historical Gamer once again, and today I'm talking to you about a sequel that I'm very excited about, although it is not coming anytime soon. It's a game that was just announced recently, or at least I just saw it recently on Steam, but the targeted launch date isn't until 2021. Still, I wanted to share my excitement because this is a game I featured a fair bit on the channel, and I streamed it a bit. And I think it's a really interesting game. It's a little bit of Hidden Agenda, this old classic DOS game from back in the, I think, late 80s, early 90s, which kind of put you in the center of a Central American post-coup country, except this was a hypothetical Middle Eastern country called Basenji, which you were put in charge of following a coup, and really tasked you with setting up a new government. And Basenji seems very loosely based on Iran and the post-revolutionary period. And I think it's a really interesting game that puts you in the shoes of this ruler of this sort of Middle Eastern state following the overthrow of a tyrant king who was propped up by the West. And the game is called Rogue State. And again, the country that you play as is Basenji. And it's a really interesting game, right? Like, they've got some funny things. You've got some different neighbors, and one of them is, like, Chickistan or something like that, and they all speak, like, this garbledygook of, like, chicken, and like, they've got a chicken image. But then you also have other things like, you know, you have your interactions with the United States are really important. Your interaction with your neighbors are important. You know, your relationship with your brother, who's sort of a rival for power, is also somewhat strained as he is often trying to overthrow you and disloyal. You have to manage the fellow members of your cabinet. You have to manage the sort of temporary parliament that's been established, and you have to navigate this country through a series of challenges over the first, I don't know, it's like 2 or 3 years where you're in charge before sort of the actual elections occur in the country, and you turn power over to your successor, or you get, you know, kicked out of power by another coup or assassinated, or a wide range of things can happen. And this is a role-playing game that kind of has some really interesting graphics and design choices. You know, the main part of the game is you inside, like, basically the version of your country's Oval Office. And you see advisors kind of come in and walk in, and you kind of talk to them. You can pick up the phone. You can call the United States. You can schedule meetings with the U.S. ambassador who can show up. You can even get an invitation from the president to come visit your country. And you can, you know, apply for financial aid from the West. You can build up your military. You can invade your neighbors. It's a really interesting political game that I wish you saw more of these types of games. I don't know how successful it was or not. The developers of this game also made a game called Precipice, which I think is more of a Cold War type of a game. I haven't played it yet, but it came out recently. And they've just announced, I don't know if it's truly a sequel to Rogue State, but they've announced Rogue State Revolutions, which they're calling, which is scheduled to come out in 2021, so it's still a ways away. But it's going to return you to Basenji. You're going to see countries like Chickistan that are bordering you. And it is returning you to the Middle Eastern version of Basenji. So again, returning you back to that period that is covered in Rogue State itself. Now, the difference is, it seems like you are in a stable country. So in the original Rogue State, you were in a post-coup country. In this case, it looks like you're going to be in charge of a somewhat stable Middle Eastern country, but your goal is to, you know, hold power and prevent a coup from coming against you. They do say it's a roguelite, and it's similar to a board game. So based off of some of these initial descriptions, I'm a little bit hesitant because it sounds like it's going to be very, very different from the original Rogue State, but I'm still pretty excited to see what they have to play with. Admittedly, this game is way far out. They just, you know, it randomly showed up on Steam as I was scrolling through some political games, and it was something that really immediately caught my eye. But I do wonder if this is going to be vastly different. The very few screenshots they have shared so far look nothing like the original Rogue State. The main similarity seems to be some of the countries that you border, the Middle Eastern premise, the Basenji premise, and then I'm not quite sure what else. There's very little information about the game available right now. All we really have so far is what's available on its Steam page, which why don't we go ahead and take a look at that. By the way, all the imagery you've seen up until this point has been imagery from the original Rogue State. So what you're seeing now are some very tentative screenshots of Rogue State Revolutions, which seems to have some... I'm not sure if it's an element of City Builder or whatever, but there's actually like a 3D map or a map anyway of sort of the region, the cities, and the different parts of the country that you can kind of look at, which is something that's new. There's, you know, some sort of global map view. But according to about the game, which again is very sparse on what they're saying so far, so I'm just going to read it verbatim. Modern Wolf presents Rogue State Revolutions, a roguelike political thriller from LRDGames, the creators of Deep Sixed and Precipice. They also created the original Rogue State. Rogue State Revolutions places you in charge of Basenji, a mostly stable Middle Eastern republic. As the president, you must juggle the demands of the voters while developing the nation economically. Oh, and don't forget, your council of ministers, many of whom are entirely loyal to you, if only you knew which ones. Designed for 3 to 4 hour play sessions, a game of Rogue State Revolutions will feature dynamically generated neighbors, ministers, and economic and political considerations. No two playthroughs will be the same, and each run can unlock new content as you stay in power for longer. The coup is coming. Can you keep your wits about you and hold on to the presidency? Rogue State Revolutions is in development for a 2021 release. So I guess as I read through that, the board game style is the one thing that feels very different from the original Rogue State, because again, the original one felt more like a very limited in terms of graphical perspective RPG, where different challenges were presented to you and you kind of had this sort of Oval Office view. The screenshots they have here look a little bit more like a city or empire manager with potentially, I'm not really sure what else. That's all we really know. So I am excited about this game, and I guess we'll see what comes, and that's all I know right now, but I did want to share it, because Rogue State was one of my favorite games, and I streamed it a little bit last year, and it's just something I wanted to talk about. I did link the description for the game in the, I put the link for the game in the description. That's it. But anyway, guys, just wanted to share this. The developer for the game is the same as the original Rogue State. I did look at that. I wasn't sure. They also, as we already said, developed Precipice, Deep Sixed, and in terms of the publisher, it's Modern Wolf, which I don't know if Modern Wolf did the original Rogue State or not. It doesn't actually... upon looking at it, they did not. It was published by Blackshell Media, so new publisher, same developer. It'll be interesting to see how this all plays out. Anyway, I don't want to make too long of a video on this because we really don't know much, but I did want to say that this is a game that I just spotted. It looks really interesting. I'm excited for it, and I wanted to share my excitement, although we'll have to wait more than a year until we figure that out. Anyway, guys, let me know your thoughts. Is this, you know, what do you think about this? Because I don't really know what to make of it. I love Basenji. I love the national anthem of Basenji, but I guess we'll have to see how this all plays out. Anyway, guys, that's going to do it for this episode. Hope you enjoyed. Until next time, this is the Historical Gamer saying thank you for watching, and I'm out.